It is that time of the week where Mr. Broomhead and I sit down and have our weekly talk. But first, Mike, you didn't get the memo. It is Flannel Friday. Where is your flannel? We're starting that for October.
It's too warm for flannel. I know it's fall. I got to wait till it's a little cooler. You know, when the girls start wearing the scarves and the Ugg boots, I'll start wearing the flannel.
Well, I don't know if we're going to have that. We're going to talk about how we have a drought right now. We might not get any rain.
Yeah, let's talk about no rain in the desert. That's a great topic.
No. So that's the thing. Like, they're saying that we had the driest summer. Monsoon is over, and now we're moving into winter. And they think we might not even have the rain and the stuff that we get from the winter.
The concern, of course, is fire season gets extended. I feel so bad for the people. And when you drive and see the forest, you know how long it takes to regenerate. But this last fire, 4 houses burned, 14 structures total. You know, it's sad to see people lose so much.
Yeah, and we've been watching California, we've been watching Oregon, and a lot of people are worried. So we just really want people, if you're going out there camping, doing stuff, please follow the rules.
Pay attention to the rules.
Yeah, that's the big thing.
Yep.
Okay. Let's switch gears, because I like how we started here. I don't know, maybe that's the way you get conversations going. You listen a little bit, you're not jumping on each other. I know everyone's been talking about it, but the debate.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been trying to keep quiet with it a little bit, but I felt like I was watching the two old men of the Muppets just go at it.
Yeah, and it was both candidates lost sight of serving the American people. In the end, when you do, you know, you do a lot of events, it's not for the person behind the mic, it's for the people in the seats. And I like a contentious debate. I like when you and I have debates, it's fun.
Right.
But when you lose sight of what you're talking about and you're just insulting each other, nobody wants, I mean, that just was a disaster.
It was. And so do you think they need to go forward with more debates?
Yeah.
You think so?
Yes, I do. I like the idea. We had at Arizona Morning News over at KTAR. They had Eric Trump on. And he floated the idea. If you remember, Joe Rogan offered to host a debate.
Yeah.
And at first I thought that was kind of an absurd idea. But it might not be a bad idea to take somebody that's out of the political journalism world and put somebody in there that can have more of a conversation. And why not update it into a podcast format and get out of the 20th century and jump into the 21st century and just give it a try.
Yeah.
It couldn't hurt. And engage a younger generation in it.
So definitely. And like I said, this debate just really showed the kind of candidates that we're going to get in a way and what's going on, but also the kind of talk that's happening, even just in public where people are talking over each other.
Just keep yapping. Just keep yapping, man.
It's crazy. So with that said, I think the debate, I think what the president and vice president are doing with this whole election thing is doing a smokescreen. And the reason why I say that is because we've been paying attention to what they're saying, what they're doing, and we're not paying attention to our own backyard. And I think that is where we're going to lose out as Arizonans, if we're not paying attention to what's on the ballot, who's on the ballot, and what's going on.
Does anybody understand the implications in the state legislature? When I moved here 25 years ago, there was a huge majority of Republicans in the House and the Senate. Right now, there is a one-seat Republican majority in the House. For the first time in as long as I know of, and who knows when, they could have a Democrat-controlled House. That would be, if I was a Democrat in Arizona, I would be ecstatic about that right now. And if I was a Republican, I would be very concerned. The ballot initiatives, are we going to raise taxes for schools, legalizing marijuana, and what that thing looks like. Are we going to do those things?
Yeah, and that's the thing that we need to be paying attention to. I do want to ask you as we get to wrap up here, I don't like what President Trump is saying. I'll respect him and call him President Trump, and you know how my feeling is. And the thing I'm not liking is that he's calling our election a fraud if he loses. Now, is he going to call it a fraud if he wins?
All right. And the only defense I'll give is this. He said he doesn't know how it's going to happen. He's concerned about the mail-in ballots. I'm not concerned about mail-in ballots, and I wish they would clarify. He did start to clarify and say unsolicited ballots. The way we do it in Maricopa County is great. You ask for a ballot, they send it to you. You get a text message when you send it back, we got your ballot back. When it's counted, they tell you your ballot's counted. That's secure. They're concerned about the unsolicited ballots, things that are be thrown in the trash. I would be concerned to a certain extent, but you can't say I'm not going to live by the results. That, especially from that high level, it's panic then.
Yeah. Right. Thank you. I'm glad we agree on that. I think it's important. So, all right. Tell them when they can find you, Monday through Friday.
Monday through Friday on 92.3 FM KTAR or the KTAR News app, 8 to noon.
There you go. And remember, it's flannel season now.
Next week.
All right. We'll check you on that.
And flannel jammies. How's that?
Ooh, wait, I have that coming up.
I will.
All right. Thanks, Mike.